Well, hey guys. Hey, here's Pastor Roger, Calvary Chapel, Maricopa. Just want to say hi to my church family. Gosh, I miss you guys. Don't you just miss one another? Yeah, this is just really, it's tough, isn't it? I know that it's hard. I know some of you are home from work, working from home. Others, you've lost your jobs, and then others, it seems like you're working tirelessly. Maybe you're working at Walmart or the grocery store, and you're just putting in crazy hours. Look, it's nuts right now. It's a crazy time. But man, we can really be trusting in the Lord for sure. And let's make sure that we're focusing on our families. Listen, right now I want to encourage you that your kids, whether they're young adults or they're high schoolers, junior high, or your little ones, look, they might have questions and they might be afraid too. So I want to encourage you as we gather together with our families during this time, focus on your kids. Love your kids. And make sure that you're reading the Bible, praying, interceding during this time. And listen, another encouragement. Look, now's not the time to be an island. Now's not that time. Reach out and stay connected. You can stay connected on our Calvary Chapel Maricopa Church Facebook page, as well as my page, and be looking for emails, church emails, letting you know what's going on. And if you're not getting mass emails from the church, you know we're sending out a big email to everybody, and maybe we don't have your contact information, I want to encourage you to email us at calvarymaricopa@gmail.com, and we'll get you within email us your information, and we'll make sure we put that in our data, so to speak, you know, and we can keep you current on what's going on. But we are looking forward to Palm Sunday. We're looking forward to Resurrection Sunday, the 5th and the 12th. And we're going to be coming to you. We're going to be doing a Facebook live stream at 10 o'clock on Sunday morning for the next two Sundays. And so we're excited. Worship, the whole thing. And so, you know, you can get together and do a Facebook watch party. You can gather your family together and sit down and study the Word with us and plug in. Like I said, no one wants to be an island. Let's stay connected during this time. Also, on our webpage, calvarymaricopa.org, you can go and download some children's curriculum during this time. You can download that, and you can be doing that so your kids can be ministered to right where they're at. So be looking for that during the next two Sundays to download that. And this coming Sunday on the 5th, we're going to be partaking of communion. I want to encourage you to go ahead and kind of scrounge those elements, have them ready. We're going to be partaking of communion at the end of the service this Sunday on Palm Sunday as a body. So we want to be looking forward to that, celebrating his death and his resurrection together, right? Together we're going to do this. This is the church's time. Now's not the time for us to drop the ball. Remember, man, the Holy Spirit lives in us. It lives in me. It lives in you, right? Our sanctuary seats 125, and we fill both services up, right? But we're limited. We're unlimited in our ability, really, to reach more people. So I want to encourage you, take the messages, take our sermons that are on YouTube and on Facebook and stuff, and share the heck out of them. And take others and share. Let's just smother social media with the Word of God. Let's just put it out there. And maybe you've got those unsaved or just maybe backslidden, or they're just really not tight with the Lord. You know, now's the time to minister. Now's the time to step in and share the love of Christ with them. Now's the time. It's look up, for our redemption draws near, right? Nearer than it was yesterday, that's for sure. And so we want to focus in, man, and trust the Lord. I'm sitting here in a vacant church. It's empty. It's not the same without you guys. It's just sheetrock and lights, man. That's all that it is. Oh, but God is so good. He is so good. And I do miss having this place full. I look forward to getting together and worshiping together with each other. So when this is all over, and it's gonna come to an end soon, right? So man, who knew 2020 would have this kind of stuff that we're dealing with? But it's not the first. As I said this last Sunday, you know, these types of things have come and they've gone, and the church has persevered, right, through these things. God is greater. God is so much greater. Listen, Jude says this as he finishes this short little epistle. I want to read to you right here, picking up in verse 20. But you, beloved, building up yourselves, build yourselves up in your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit. Now is the time to be interceding and praying and not being slack, right? Keep yourselves in the love of God. Keep yourselves there, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ unto eternal life. We're looking for that day, right? He's coming back for his bride. And then it says, and on some have compassion, making a distinction. Oh man, we can win some with grace and with love. And then he goes on in 23, but others save with fear, pulling them out of the fire. Right? You look, man, you know, when he comes back, hell's a reality. It's, you know, it's about life, an abundant life here, but it's also still about heaven and it's still about hell. Right? This is about eternity. It's about the love of God. He's righteous. He's holy. Right? He's God. Let's share that with people. Now to him who is able to keep you and I from stumbling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. Oh, he wants to present you and I faultless. And it's his joy to do so. It just warms his heart. He wants you so bad. I said, Sunday, God wants you. He wants your neighbor. He wants your kids. He wants you. And when we look at the gospel, and we look at the cross, and we look at the resurrection, it's all because God wants you. He wants me. He wants to embrace us. He loves us. The love of God is chasing after us. This pandemic, that's what it says to me. God loves me. And now's the time for me to trust him even more than ever before. Even with an empty church. Pastors. Our churches are empty. This is our pastor's greatest fear. That our churches are empty and that nobody shows up for our preaching. That's our greatest fear. And now all these pastors, we're all teaching to empty rooms. Yeah. God's saying, hey, preacher, you need to trust me. Right? You need to trust me. But like maybe just now, the message can go out and instead of reaching 250, it can reach thousands. Our little church could just reach thousands. The opportunities are endless. Oh, God wants to present you faultless to the glory of our Savior, who alone is wise. Be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. God is so good. We're trusting him. And I know some of you parents, man, you're homeschooling your kids. You're like, I'm not a homeschool parent. This is a whole new thing, right? And churches are just having to adapt, and families are having to adapt. You're having to adapt at work, all kinds of stuff. You know, now's the time to be the church. Now's the time for us to shine, right? Let us not lose our brightness and let us not lose our saltiness. Let's trust the Lord. All right? Stay connected. And then we're looking forward to the next two Sundays for sure. We're going to celebrate Jesus Christ and the power of the resurrection. Right? The power of the cross. It's all about Jesus. It's all about Jesus. It's not about this pandemic. God bless you and I love you so much. I'm looking forward to seeing you and hugging you all soon. You gotta shut this off. How do I finish?